phones as it may mess with the equipment. Also, there are two exits backstage either side, as well as an exit to your right and to your left in case of an emergency.
We definitely encourage you to sing along to most of the songs as you will always know them. And most importantly, enjoy the show.
You could describe the show in one word, what would it be?
Everyone said cringy, didn't they?
Cringy.
Cringy.
So cringy.
Kind of cringy.
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 Cringe.
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 Cheesy. A bit dodgy.
Magical.
Hilarious. Juicy. Crazy.
No, I don't use that word.
Yes.
Electric.
Wild.
What are your roles in the show? Of course.
Tech team. Microphone. Single speaker. Sentiment.
A dancer in the background.
I'll be on Strictly next year.
Of course.
A dancer.
I'm in the chorus and on costume hair and makeup committee.
Both in the chorus.
Tech team.
Technical team.
What character are you playing?
I will be
the style girl.
Yes.
I am the director of Back to the 80s and choreographer of Back to the 80s. But I did have assistant director Erica help me so much. Their panel also helped me a lot and choreography as well. Amy was good help there.
Who in the show is the most loved at heart?
Arcady.
Arcady. Amy or
Arcady?
Arcady.
Arcady.
Arcady or
Amy?
Arcady. As I guess more people would say, me, because my class like acts all like cool, is the best of everyone, so probably myself.
Amy.
Amy's enthusiasm, but it's very like the Cindy enthusiasm that I gave.
Without any context, what is your favourite line in the show? In the only difference
between you and who crap is the bucket?
Toys.
My for money, no, come later. Chill fuck.
It's a CD. What do you think of Miss Danny and Miss Mantis?
I think they're brilliant. They treat it as like a professional show, which is the way to do it.
Amazing. They've built this whole thing from the bottom up. Most people have never acted ever in the we're doing this.
You do a good job.
They're good at their job.
They're very inspirational.
Really nice. They're brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Very good teacher. Amazing teachers.
They're amazing personality.
Satisfactory.
Is
that anything
fun?
She
really knows what she wants to do in the whole thing. Like, you can see it when she's like talking about like, dancing and stuff like that.
Where is chorus, but she still knows all those my name.
What do you think of that one in the show?
Overall, I've never come across such a committed group before. Even when it comes to props, publicity, it's just a full team effort. To be honest, I could only get the scripts out, I could give the dances out, but other than that, all I could do was hope for commitment from team wise to get the show together, and thankfully they brought it.
What do you think of Money's Hero of the Ladies?
Flashy clothes,
silly fun.
Crazy outfit, bad fashion.
Bad hair, what's
crazy hair. Mad hair.
Weird hairstyle.
Weird hair.
Technicolor. Lots of different colors.
Lots of colors.
Color.
Color. Colors.
Colors.
Transform.
Shoulder pads.
Hippies.
Can you shut up?
Shut up.
We're doing an interview.
What was your favourite part of doing the show?
Rehearsals.
I love going to rehearsals.
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 Rehearsals for the
guys. Rehearsals is probably the best thing that's ever happened in T1.
Getting a class, definitely. 6 classes a week.
First getting a class, honestly.
Okay, yeah, class of the sound demonstration we did with John was pretty decent.
Talking to John, getting to John, not
incredible. Working with John, very funny man, very funny man.
Just seeing everyone outside of their comfort zone.
Everyone's getting along more. There are people that I've been talking to that I've been talking to ever.
Watching the students develop into their characters. I definitely don't think I've laughed so much in rehearsal before.
Yeah, it's a lot of class, but class.
What's your favourite song in this show?
500 Miles.
500 Miles.
500 Miles.
I've never heard of it.
Kids in America.
Kids in America.
Oh, let's hear for the boy. Is that true?
Footloose. Footloose, yeah, Footloose.
Girls just one half one.
Girls just one half one.
Sorry.
Girls
songs.
On the mirror.
And finally, what would you say to anyone seeing this show for the first time?
Be quiet.
Prepare yourself.
Go to love
with
Enjoy.
Sit back, relax, enjoy the show. I know it's cringy, but you have to do it.
Okay, you see it.
Focus on me, because I need help. I'm stretching.
Yeah, it was full of mine.
Do not blink, don't move from your seats, because every second has a special in the moment.
Music for the new millennium, and now, for all you members of Generation X out there, here's a blast from the past, coming at you from almost 15 years ago, straight out of the heart of the Electric 80s. The era that gave us MC Hammer, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Stonewashed Down, and of course, the Rubik's Cube.
I'm not the DJ now, but it's not the time. welcome to your final year at William Ocean High School. Unfortunately, Principal Ronald McDonald could not be here this morning, but he's asked me to welcome you all and say a special William Ocean Hi to all of our students. For those of you joining us this year, my name is Mr. Cocker. Hi, I'm the head of mathematics at this school. I would also like to take this opportunity to introduce you all to your senior student coordinator, Ms. Brandon. Ms. Brandon.
Oh. Thank you, Mr. Cocker. Our first job this year is to select our senior year presidents. The three candidates running are Corey Palmer, Michael Salmon, and Fergal McFerrin. Now, election day is next Friday, and that is when our candidates will be giving their election presentations. But for now, I would like each candidate to come up to the front and address the class. Corey, could you start us off?
Hi everyone. As you all know, my name is Corey Palmer, and I'm here with my two best friends and vice presidential candidates, Alf Bueller and Kurt Keaton. We have a lot of exciting ideas for our senior year, including a couple of ideas we've been working on. Trust me, they'll blow you away! We'll reveal them at the rally next Friday.
Yeah!
Anyway, in closing, let me just say this will be an awesome final year, and Alf, Kirk and I will do absolutely everything we can to make this remembered as the best senior year to ever graduate from William Ocean High!
That was nice, Corey. Our next candidate is Michael Salmon.
Michael Feller, the coolest guy in school. Movie star looks, natural athlete, captain of the football team, and most impressively of all, every girl in the school threw themselves at him. Michael and his friends were the kinds of guys someone like me could never hope to compete with.
My fellow seniors, this is going to be an awesome year. Let me introduce you to the only team worthy of being your student leaders. And just in case you've been living under a rock for the last 4 years, my name is Michael Feldman. My vice presidential candidates will be Billy Arnold, Tiffany Houston, and Cindy Gibson, who I'm sure needs no introduction. Right, guys?
Yeah!
Oh, shut up, Michael!
And that was Cindy Gibson, the motor mouth gossip of the school. She was the kind of girl who could say whatever she liked, and she knew it.
Why don't you guys grow up, get with it, we're called seniors for a reason.
At Rally Day, you will see our full proposal. Oh, and guys, you better be there. There will be cheerleaders.
Yeah.
That is my election promise to you. If you elect me as president, I guarantee that William Ocean Rock will. No, the William Ocean will have a lot. We are senior dudes. Let's make this the most radical year of our lives.
Okay, Michael, thank you. We shall wait with basic breath, I'm sure. Our third and final candidate is Fergal McFerrin.
Alf, Kirk, and I may not be the coolest Michael and his gang, but compared to Fergal, we were Michael Jackson, Michael J. Fox, and Rick Astley, all rolled into one. I'm sure every school had one. The guy who never fit in.
Senior class, my name is Fergal Bobby McFerrin III, and I'm a candidate for student presidency. I'd like to introduce my VPs, Laura Brown and Debbie Fox. Fellow seniors, the 80s are drawing to a close, and I believe that technology is the way of the future. I want to make William Ocean High the most technologically advanced school in this country. A recent study has shown that if silicon chip technology continues to advance at its current exponential rate, we can have computers twice, even three times the power of Commodore 64 sitting on our very desks. And that's just the beginning. We can get all the computers in the world talking to each other using hypertext transfer protocol. We can get black computers to be easy for anyone to use with the graphic user interface. DOS would be a relic of the past. Sitting in your home at your desk, the question would be, where do I want to go today?
Yes, thank you very much. You're going to hear all about the election day.
But Miss Brennan, you're not finished yet.
Now, just remember, attendance for election day is mandatory. I will see you all there. You are dismissed.
Well, I think that could set you up.
Hey, Tiff. How are you doing?
Hey, Corey, I'm
good.
How
come
you were coming yesterday? I
can't
believe she
looks
with
you. Oh, I have to go back to the shopping with my mom.
Oh, cool.
I can't believe it's my senior year.
I know, it's gonna be so awesome.
Yeah, it's already a blast.
Corey, tell me honestly. There's this guy. Oh, heck, I'm just gonna go straight at him. Do you think that Michael Feldman likes me? Cindy thinks he has a crush on me.
I don't know, I guess he probably does, but why wouldn't he? You're funny, intelligent, and beautiful.
And Michael's such a sweet guy, and he's cute, don't you think?
I don't know, his ears are really big, and he has-
Hey, do you think? I watched him meet some girls in my dance class, the year he's senior, whoa, this is Nanny and Kimberly, they're twins, it's Nanny. Hey, everyone just follow us, man. Hey, this is my neighbor, Corey.
No, he's the guy. Who are the guys over there?
Michael Fan, the most radical guy at the school. The guy next to Billy Arnold, and he's gonna crush on me. The other two are Lionel and Kiwi. Maybe I need to do something
to them. Hey, girls. What's up? Hey, I'm Michael.
Hey, Michael. This is Mel and Kim. They're twins.
Twins?
Twins? Did you guys get to college or something?
You're a moron.
Look at them.
Anyway, me and the guys are going roller skating Friday night. If you want to come along, that would be pretty cool.
That'd be great!
Yeah, cool.
Okay, awesome. How was summer, Tim?
I had such a great time.
How come you guys went on it at a price?
We were working. Some of us have to keep his crunchy room.
It was wild. I sometimes didn't get home until 6 a.m. My parents were such a drag. I'm not totally freaked out.
Yeah, guys were calling me every night. My dad kept freaking out and saying, it's too late.
Oh, you girls just sound so tough. Now do it every night.
Oh,
be thankful you got to have fun over the summer.
Yeah, we were working the entire time. It was exhausting.
Oh, you must have paid a few times.
No, we all had summer jobs. I was fine at working at a Coca-Cola factory, saving up to buy my car.
You guys don't know how good you got. If you don't have pay, you pay for us to go out partying.
Yeah, I was actually looking forward to going back to school.
You're kidding, right?
Nope, I can't wait to get out of there.
Thank you.
Hi guys.
Hey, what took you so long?
I'm working on this awesome election idea. Okay, I'm just gonna say hi to Tiffany. Hi girls.
Hey Corey.
Hi Corey, great to see you.
Thanks, I'm maybe getting a bike for my birthday.
So, what's up?
Oh, not much. What are you guys up to?
Corey, I'm like, you have to go for my breakfast.
Oh. Hey Tiffany, do you want some shoes at my place tomorrow?
I'm sorry, Corey. I just told Michael and I play football. Maybe I'll catch next week.
Anyways, I better get back to the garden. We're supposed to be working on our election campaign.
How's it coming along?
Wicked. We've got some really cool ideas.
I don't even know where I'm going, Corey. I think that was Tiffany, Michael, and I. Cindy,
we don't know that.
Yeah, right.
So how's your campaign coming along?
Better if we could ever get Michael and the guys to sit down and talk to us about it.
Anyway, I better get back to the guys. Check you later. Alright, I'm back.
Did you see A-Team yesterday?
Of course I did. What you looking at, fool? Guys, come on, we have to concentrate. Election day is tomorrow.
Corey, pull my finger.
Get out of here, we're not in first grade.
What do you mean? I was just joking around.
Yeah, you're pre-dancers. You need to know. Well, this election day is really important to me. It's senior year. We'll remember this forever.
It's flying by already. Before you know it, we'll be in the 90s. What do you think those will be like?
Flying saucers? Humans that can fly?
Yeah, that's
like the greatest American hero.
We won't be able to fly, but our cars will talk. Well, I got Knight Rider.
David Hasselhoff is so cool.
You said it, man.
Actually, guys, I don't think a lot will change. We'll be flying, our cars will talk, and people still live in normal houses. David Hasselhoff will still be cool, but only in Germany.
Yeah, and the Russians will be our friends.
But by the year 2000, we'll all have mobile telephones that will fit in the palm of our hands.
You're not typical. This is never going to happen.
A prophet is always mocked in his own lifetime.
Hello?
Yes? Yes? Oh my. Okay, I have to go and develop a new software that will enable computers to talk to each other over Bill's house.
Not Gabe. He is such a nerd. How can his dad spend time with him?
Mark my words, one day we're both going to make a lot of money out of computers.
Come on, we don't have much time.
So are you finally going to tell us this amazing plan you've been working on?
Yeah, here it is. We're going to hold a concert at the school.
A concert?
What? Yeah. To raise money. Remember, Bad Day in USA for Africa?
Of course.
Well, we're going to hold a concert at the school. We'll charge money for people to come see it.
Yeah, and we can tell everyone that we're raising money for the biggest fund the city has ever seen.
Now you're getting the idea.
Dude, I love when a plan comes together.
Hey, I'm finished. Michael, Billy, no!
Well, hey there.
Okay, Michael, hurry up and go get dressed. You have to get started on the election stuff. Hurry, the guys have already done a lot so far, so we better get started.
Yeah. Well, why don't you head home? And I'll meet you there.
Okay, see you in half hour.
Bye!
Hey, Palmer. How's the election stuff going?
Okay.
Study?
Maybe.
Oh, sorry. Let me help you with that.
It's okay. We're finished. We're gone.
Good luck tomorrow, dude. I hope you can have the humiliation of losing.
Such a jerk, man.
Guys. I got his proposal.
Wicked.
Thank you.
president will be chosen.
Now we have rotated proposals from each of our candidates. Michael Feldman has volunteered to go first. So without any further ado, please welcome your first candidate.
Go Mickey!
Thank you.
That's that. Michael Feldman became president by stealing my idea. I never told Tiffany what happened. She never would have believed me anyway. After the election, Kirk, Alf, and I couldn't help but feel disappointed. And the pressure of senior year caused me to start having nightmares.
It's all tied up in the 10th inning. Al Buehler steps up to the plate, throws the pitch. Buehler swings. It's flying over the fence. Al Buehler won the World Series for the Yankees.
Congratulations, Maggio.
Can you imagine a world without baseball? It would suck.
A world without baseball?
What are you talking about, Matt?
Some of the stuff Earl said on election day got me. What if everything we love gets replaced in the future?
Dude, what are you talking about?
What if there are no space invaders or Pac-Man in the future?
Don't worry about it, Matt. Cool stuff like that will never go to place.
Yeah, some things are so good, they'll be here forever. Like, hyper-colored t-shirts.
And Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Cowabunga!
Yours in a half shell, turtle power.
Who would win in a lightsaber battle between Darth Vader and Yoda?
Yoda was too old and short. Vader would come in no time.
What if Yoda was 200 years younger and really tall?
Darth would still come easy.
What if Darth wasn't feeling well at all? Like, had a really bad fall?
Guys, play out the Star Wars. We must see those films like 20 times each. They're starting to be weird things in my head.
What do you mean?
Corey?
I keep having dreams that I'm Luke Skywalker.
Part to the dark side, it is.
Well, you two geeks caused it. All you two ever heard talk about are bookies and Ewoks.
Hey, that's not all we talk about.
We talk about girls and stuff too.
Yeah, when?
New colors on the Atari, new graphics?
Well, you better get going. My parents are going to catch me up this late.
Yeah.
Don't want folks to be getting worried. See you school tomorrow.
You know? Day off.
Have a nice day off.
And Corey, just remember, the Force will be with you always.
The truth is, I only told them half the story. Every night I dreamed that Tiffany and I were dancing through life together, hand in hand. Everything was perfect. I was Luke Skywalker and she was my Princess Leia. Barely a night went by when I didn't have that dream.
Good night, Princess.
I can't believe myself. Suddenly I'm up on top of the world. It should have been somebody else.
So the year continued, and after winter break, a new girl arrived, William Ocean High.
Billy Arnold?
Present.
William Astley?
Present.
Al Buehler? 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 Don, right.
Okay, everyone, I would like to introduce a new student to our school. Her name is Ivy. Please make her feel welcome. Let us show her how friendly we are here in William Ocean. Eileen, do you want to say hi?
Hi, my name is Eileen. I don't know what else to say.
That was good.
And she'll all make an effort to talk to
Eileen, and she'll fit in no time at all.
Thanks, Mr. Crocker.
Now, I've an announcement to make. Mr. Miyagi has asked me to remind you all that his bonsai classes start today at lunchtime. Anyone who's interested should go to room 2B when the bell rings. 2B or not 2B?
Oh my god!
Open up your books to page 14.
Hi, everyone.
This is Kurt. Welcome to the Lowe's.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm Tiffany. These are my friends. Cindy, Mal, and Kim. How did this go so far?
It's good, I guess. Hopefully I don't feel like home soon.
Hey, who was it on your shoulder?
Oh, no.
Don't worry, they're not sure when you get to know them.
I hope so.
Hi, I'm Nora! And I'm Debbie!
Nora and Debbie are so weird. One day I was driving by Debbie's house and I saw her through the window kissing poster of Rick Springfield. Her whole Women's Herd posters of Corey Haim, Anthony Michael Hall, Don Johnson, and you won't believe this, the Proclaimers.
Not her, too. Tiffany has this tint for the Proclaimers as well. I can't believe all these girls think they're cute. They look like two Scottish burgers with glasses.
Now, poor girl has no idea who she's making friends with. Nor has she ever had a job. Neither of them have ever had a boyfriend.
We've never had girlfriends either.
Well, at least we don't make them look like these posters in our room.
I guess.
You've got to talk to Mr. Cocker.
Okay, I'm going. Mr. Cocker?
Yes, Corey. What is it?
Well, it's been a long time since Election Day, and apparently Michael no longer wants to do the concert idea.
Oh, he hasn't told me that.
Well, he said he was too busy with football or something. But I was hoping you'd let me and my friends put it on.
Great idea. Got my help.
Well, you could say the whole concert idea was yours, and you could...
Attention! Everybody! Corey has decided to plan a concert for you all. Isn't that wonderful of him?
Thanks for keeping it quiet.
So, Eileen, do you have a boyfriend?
I did, but we had to break up when I came here. It was my longest boyfriend, and it was majorly serious. We've been going out to quit two entire weeks.
Farrah, that is serious!
So, what are the boys like here? Are you girls dating?
There's Elton, John, Vaughn, and Jody. Yeah, I've had brilliant.
Well, are you dating at the moment?
His name is Don. I'm an actor.
Gorgeous.
And I'm dating a guy named Anthony. We are so in love with each other.
When can I meet them?
Probably not for a while. They're both in Miami on business.
Well, what are they like?
Well, how should we describe them?
Yeah, let's see.
Thank you.
She like, well, I may forgive you if you give me a kiss.
Oh, really?
Well, maybe.
Stevie, not at school. What if the kids see us?
Oh, come on. Loosen up. Live life on the wild side. Danger. It's my good plan.
Mr. Fucker, come quick! Virgil's getting broken real badly! Hurry to make a meat to be out of him!
Who is it this time? Michael? Billy?
No. Two junior girls.
But hurry, or there'll be nothing left of them!
I'll see to this. You go home, get changed, I'll pick you up at 8.
Deal.
No. Date.
much of the Proclaimer twins were cute.
Yeah, you told me that too.
Yeah, they are, in a long-distance sort of way. Would you two like it if I dressed in my pajama and went walking around the streets?
Well, yeah.
Thank you.
I don't want to see you again.
Follow each other on the wing and no way.
to William Ocean High School. Please put your hands together for the superstars of the senior class as they present the Ocean Aid for Africa concert.
Together, standing strong. parents were there, except for mine. Mom and Dad had traveled to Indianapolis for a business trip. 2 weeks, and that meant only one thing.
Don't panic, don't you see? This is our chance to find you the coming girl.
You know what I mean.
Yeah, this part rocks. We'll never be left out again.
Yeah, don't panic, though. I spent the whole afternoon setting up my house. We have food and drinks. This is gonna be totally awesome.
See you, guys!
See you there.
It's
gonna be totally awesome. Tonight we're gonna party like it's 1999.
What part is the most ready?
15 miles, straight down the Atlanta Highway.
Cool, check you later.
I always have to run it home.
Guys, I've thought of everything. I painted the sign left on the side of the road that says 15 miles to the love shack.
This is totally awesome.
Hey, Palmer, my friend forgot their erections again. How did you get there?
Now
time marches on, and our senior year rapidly disappears. I guess we all grew up in our own ways. Michael and his gang continue to send letters to Eileen.
Now, put it there after English.
No, I'll do it myself. You know what, guys? I think it's finally time to reveal the identity of our secret admirer. Michael fell.
Quick, here she comes. Come on, let's get out of here.
So Fergal had taken up some extracurricular study with our groundskeeper, Mr. Miyagi, after school.
Wax on, wax off. Mr. Miyagi wants me to practice for at least half an hour every day. He says to become a fully developed grasshopper, one with his head and heart to guide the hands. Pink effect. Wax on.
And as it got toward the end of the year and her school prom approach, Eileen's dreams finally came true.
Hey, guys.
Another letter? Give me it. Read it out loud. Dear Eileen, that's you. Tonight I celebrate my love for you. These past few months have been tough, but I'm still standing after all this time. And when the going gets tough, the tough get going.
He's so cool.
I'm never going to give you up. Never going to let you down. Never going to turn around and desert you. Never going to make you cry. Never going to say goodbye. Never going to tell a lie and hurt you. If you'll be mine, then heaven is a place on earth. Forever yours, Michael Feldman.
Michael, are you serious?
Michael Feldman's totally in love with you!
I can't wait till the 6th day of the week. I've got my soul.
I can't believe it. I'll teach you we can try.
I know, it's so exciting. It'll give us a free.
Why would you need to try? That's what guys are for. Michael and Ryan already have their lives, and Billy gets his next week. And guess what? Michael's parents just bought me a new car.
Yeah, that's great. When it's old, you should call it flattery.
Flattery?
What?
Because it won't get him anywhere.
Hey, Tiffany.
Hey! You finally got it!
Yeah, can I speak to you for a moment?
Yeah, sure.
Well, I got this new bike, and it can fit two people, so I was wondering, do you want to go for a double?
Cocker is losing it, man. I swear, I saw him crying in the lunchroom yesterday.
Yeah, something bad must be going on.
Man, it must be crazy.
You are such a nerd.
Thank you.
Oh, telling you, Riley, I think my frog.
That would be so totally awesome.
I mean, I know he loves me, but going out with me in public to the prom, it's a big step for him.
Well, what did the letter say?
That his love grows for me more and more each day, and he has something big to ask me, but he's waiting for the right moment.
Well, I'll go to the prom naked if he doesn't ask you to go. What else could the big something be?
Got the letter? Put it in quick.
We'll watch a show prominent at a date, then we'll let her know the truth.
Sounds like a great plan.
Gee, I hope so. I can't wait any longer. Let's go see if there's another letter from him.
Hey, Michael. What are you guys doing?
Nothing actually. Got to get going.
No, no, wait a minute. I think it's time to reveal the truth about you and Eileen. What you guys don't know is your pal Michael up in here has been in love with Eileen for ages.
And he just asked me to prom. Oh, Michael, I knew he wouldn't let me down.
I would love to go to prom with you.
Wait, you aren't actually planning to go to prom with her, are you?
No, wait a minute.
Of course.
I'm not.
What do you mean?
Michael would have been promising for $1 million.
What, Michael?
Don't have a cow. I was just messing with you, you know?
Yeah, we were glaring together as a joke. Just having fun.
So after all this time, none of it was true? You never liked me?
No, not really.
Michael, you're such a jerk! The only difference between you and a bucket of crap is the bucket. Come on, Ivan.
Whoa, freak out, why don't you?
I can't believe what I just heard. How could you be so cruel?
Just having fun.
Fun? How do you think poor Eileen feels?
Chill out. What do you want me to do?
Nothing. And I don't want you to come near me ever again. You're not the guy I thought you were. I can't believe I wasted all this year with you.
Come on. You can't be serious. You can't break up with me. Promise, tomorrow night. Who will I go with?
I couldn't care less. It's over, Michael.
Oh yeah? Well, I got any girl. You'll be begging to take me back.
What a woman.
Lila.
I can't believe you guys just did that. No, I have something to say. What you guys did to Eileen is unforgivable. I demand you go and apologize to her immediately.
Oh, yeah. Well, what are you going to do if I don't, Virgil?
I must warn you, I'm highly trained in a number of martial arts. These are not hands, they're legal defense weapons.
Legal defense weapons.
Oh, yeah? Well, defend this.
Miss Miyagi, I need help.
Ferguson, remember what I said to you. If you're really angry at someone, count to 10, take deep breaths, and beat the living crap out of them.
Okay, Miss Miyagi! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You want a piece, Miss?
Well, if that's what you want, but if you want somebody to talk to, well, I can listen.
My whole life is falling apart. I've been trying so hard to fit in, and after 6 months I thought I was finally there. But it turns out everyone's been laughing at me this whole time.
No, they haven't.
Yes, they have. Did you know that Michael was sending me fake love letters from the first day I got here?
No, but Michael's a jerk. Not all of us guys are like him.
I guess.
Corey, what did what just happened?
Don't worry, Eileen. Things will get better, I promise.
How do you know that?
Well, they can't get any worse, can they? Guys, come on, Eileen needs to keep cheering up. She thinks that nobody likes her.
Of course we like you. You're great.
Thanks.
If it makes you feel any better, someone just stood up for you and had a fight with Michael, and won. You won't believe who it was.
Someone fought Michael for me?
Fergal.
Fergal?
Yeah, he was a real hero. He knocked him out with a swift kick to the head.
That's so sweet of him. I can't believe you did that for me.
You see, we do like you here. Guys, come on, join in.
Thank you.
finally here. The end of our school lives. We waited for this night our entire lives. And we were going to make sure it was a night we would never forget. Laura and Debbie are now millionaires. They set up a dating agency. You may have heard of it. eHarmony. Fergal and Eileen went on to get married 2 years after college. Most of Fergal's crazy ideas came true. And he's also a millionaire now, having helped pioneer the World Wide Web. Cindy and Billy were never going to last. She's now a Democratic politician, and he went on to own a chain of roller rinks with Lionel and Huey. When skating went out of fashion, they had the bulldozers replaced with parking garages. Mel and Kim, they married twins from England named Matt and Luke. They both have two sets of triplets and are now in the Guinness Book of World Records. Michael Feldman, he went on and played in the NFL for a few years, but a nasty groin injury forced him into early retirement. He's had two wives and now lives in New Orleans with his four children. Miss Brannigan and Mr. Cocker finally let bygones be bygones and decided to tie the knot. She still teaches at William Ocean High, and he is the new principal. The lads and I, we still see each other. We play golf once in a while. Kirk met a beautiful girl in Disneyland and married her. Alf, well, he's destined to be a bachelor for life. And as for Tiffany and me, well, we never did get married. In fact, I haven't heard from her in about 2 years. I was at a wedding in Chicago. She has two beautiful daughters, both with a spitting image of her. And as for me, well, I'm happy and healthy and single. I'm dating at the moment, so we'll see how that goes. You know, it's funny. Life moves pretty fast, and it takes us all along with it. Sure, things don't always work out the way we thought when we were 17, but that's okay. I still love looking back at my old school days and the memories that we created that will live on forever in here.
Stop! Thank you. Good night.